Hello, Mayumi. So I want to review a tarot deck, and the deck I want to review is this one, Tarot Familiars. I have had my eye on this deck for some time before it was published. I really like working with animals and are a huge fan of animals in general, so I thought that even if this deck weren't exactly for me, then it would at least be nice pictures of animals. So let's have a look at it, shall we? I will have to say that while this is a cardboard box, the box is the card stock of the box is pretty good, so it will last you for a little while. Though of course, if you're gonna take the deck in and out of the box a lot of times, it is often best to get a bag or something. So let's start, as I usually do, with the little white book, or in this case, the little black book. And let me just go through who made this. I think it says there somewhere. It's by Lisa Parker, and she also seems to be the one that, and it's Fernier that's published it. Yes. These are one of the books that I really hate the format of, because you basically fold it out. And I think it's the standard five languages of this little booklet, isn't it? Yes, it's Spanish, English, French, Dutch, and Portuguese. So, let's find English, shall we? It is not the easiest to work around with, because here we have English, because of the format of it. But basically we have a what is tarot. Then we have the major arcana, which gives you little blurbs like this. And let's just find the minor arcana, which also has little blurbs about the same size as the major ones. Everything gets blurbs. Cups. And then we have basically your standard Celtic cross layout. I haven't seen those for a little while. There was a while where every tarot deck you bought had the Celtic cross layout in it. It was like, you will get shot if you publish a tarot deck without the Celtic cross layout in the box. But it has been some variation for a while, but it's starting to crop up again. And don't get me wrong, the Celtic cross is a pretty good layout to work with. If you have some space, it's a very, very nice layout. But since it's everywhere, it's very nice to get something different as well. So let's have a look at the deck. Here we have the various title cards, things. We don't need those. And that should be it. Yeah, here we have them. So here we go. The cards are a little bit smaller than your regular tarot. And for some people, that can be really, really nice. Because tarot cards can be pretty big, and if you have small hands, that can be an issue. So, as you can see, we have various animal pictures, lots of cats, but a little bit different too. And it's not a traditional deck. It's definitely not basing itself around the Rider White. And the thing is, I have seen a lot of these images in various fantasy stores on posters and mugs and t-shirts before from this artist. So I have, since at times the symbolism doesn't really seem to fit all that well, I have this nagging suspicion that here, somebody has come to an artist and said, you know what? You have a lot of pictures in your portfolio, lady. Would you like to make a tarot deck? And the reason why the camera is bouncing now is that my cat decided to rub her nose against my computer. She wants attention. Do you want to help me review the deck mod? No? No. Now she goes to find some place to sleep. So yeah, continuing on. Like, I have a cup with this one on it, and I've seen a t-shirt with this one. So I suspect that she has been offered to do a tarot deck. She has scrunched together what she has that can fit. And perhaps painted a few new ones to fill in the gaps. And that's the problem. For example, okay, this is the devil card. How does this in any way, shape or form match the symbolism of the devil? We have a bear, which is the wolf. It's a wolf with a pentagram behind him and some Celtic knots and some flames. How does this in any way, shape or form fit the symbolism of the devil in tarot? At least here we have a tower and some lightning, so there's that, but you still don't get that sense of destruction that is in the tower. This one actually fit pretty well for the star. The moon fit well, little bunny rabbit here. The sun does not fit whatsoever. One of my favorite coffee mugs has this design on it, with this cat reading tarot. I think it's adorable. It's one of my favorite fantasy art at the moment, and I'm obsessed with that mug. I have it here somewhere. Had coffee of it not long ago, but now I can't seem to find it. It's probably in the washer. The dishwasher? Yeah, the dishwasher, because it wouldn't be good to put a cup in the washer. Now would it? But yes. And I bought that. I mean, this deck came out this year, and I bought that cup last year, and then it was on sale. So I think some of these are old images. But don't get me wrong, the pictures are very, very pretty. Unfortunately, it is not fully illustrated. The minor arcana is just basically, except pentacles has pentagrams. Let's move on. The court cards are illustrated. So you have wolves for pentacles. Here we have some ace and then cups. Which are just done. Cups. And let's find the court cards for the cups are owls. Love owls, but yes. Why owls for cups? Wouldn't fish have been better, but I can to a certain degree understand ravens for swords, though. These are however clearly not swords, they are daggers, but let's not be nitpicky, people. But yeah, it's not fully illustrated. Not all of the images fit with the actual tarot card. So we have again a case of artist does tarot with having no real knowledge of the tarot and just reusing a lot of images that she has already painted and publishing a deck. This makes the deck somewhat useless as a tarot deck. So don't get me wrong. You can find that these images work with you, and knowing what the various tarot deck, what the various tarot cards is supposed to mean, you can decide that, you can get some use out of it, absolutely. And it's definitely very pretty. It's fantasy art, well-drawn fantasy art with animals, and many of these cards are very, very beautiful, but I so wish that the This is also a common one that there's a lot of phone cases and such that has this image. Lots of cheap phone cases that has this stolen image on it. So yeah. I just wish that one that made this deck would have spent more time actually working on making a tarot deck and making the symbolism actually fit. So other than that, the card stock quality is pretty okay. This is completely okay. This will last you for some time. The back of the cards I hate. It has writing on it. I do not like card backs that have writing on it. And if it didn't have that, it would have been very nice because it would have just been this subtle Celtic with pentagrams design, which is really nice, and which, other than the pentagrams direction, would be fairly reversible. But with that writing on it, that just looks cheap. So yeah, what do I think about this deck? It's beautiful. I wish that the image itself was bigger, that it didn't have this enormous bit of frame around it, because that's a little bit they could have just extended the image to the entire card. I like that it is a deck with a little bit smaller cards that will fit well for a lot of people. It's very well drawn, and the cardstock is good. It's shiny but not too shiny, and the overall basically build quality is good. It is, however, a collection of art images. If you like the images of this artist, which I do, then this is a fairly cheap way of getting a bunch of her images. It can be used if you go just by what the cards are. They are similar enough that you can get the image. So if you say, oh, well, that's judgment, it means so and so and so, and you don't go anything by what's on the card, no intuitive reading by the images, nothing like that, then it can be used. If you in any way, shape or form use the images of the cards in reading, like most of us do, then this is a completely useless deck. And that's a shame, because there's so much that's nice about it. I wish artists would stop doing that, or at least that they would mark it when they did. Meaning, I would have no problem if they made decks and they basically said, hey, this is an art deck. It's just a way for me to publish 22 or 78 images of mine that you can purchase. If they were honest about that, I would have no issue with it whatsoever. But decks like this sort of pisses me a bit off, because it's just a collection of the artist's artwork. It's not adjusted to the cards. It's not the symbolism. There's nothing. It's just a money grab. So I will have to give this deck 5 out of 10. It's a nice enough collection of art. And if you just want something to play around with, I guess it will do. But if you're actually serious about the tarot, this isn't gonna do much for you. The only basically spiritual use I can see of this deck is to use the images to contact, for example, animal spirits and such, having them on the altar and using them in that way. That they can have some use for. Anything else? There's just symbolism is all wrong. There isn't any thought to symbolism in there. It's just basically, oh, I have a lot of images. Let me just slap them on tarot cards. Let me see. Judgment will be a cat reading tarot. Because that's what that card's about. And that's what basically what annoys me, because yeah, it doesn't fit. And it's just a money grab. But yeah, if you want some pretty fantasy art, you'll get it here. If you want a tarot deck, look elsewhere. And if this one would actually like to get back in this box, That would be nice. And it's such a shame because it's such good build quality. And I would so really like to enjoy this deck. And I had my eye on it for so long. But yeah. And it's also pretty cheap that she hasn't actually fully illustrated the miners. That's just cheap. So yeah. The art gets a thumbs up, but as a tarot deck, it sucks. And that's my review of Tarot Familiars. I hope you have enjoyed this review. Have a great day, and blessed be, and happy Espat. Hope you will all enjoy the full moon tonight. Bye!